to our God.
Glory,
hallelujah. It's to our God. Every praise.
Every praise.
Every praise.
Every praise.
It's to our God.
Oh, yes.
Pick it up one more time. Every praise.
Every praise.
Every word of worship.
Oh, yes. Oh, oh. Thank you, Jesus.
Every praise is to our God. I don't care how you're feeling right now. Sing hallelujah. To our God. Glory,
hallelujah.
Every praise.
Every praise
is to our God. Hey, this is what I love. God, my Savior.
Yes, God, our Savior.
God,
our healer.
God, my deliverer.
Come on here. Yes, he is. Yes, he is.
Yes, he is.
Come on and worship with us, family. Come on, Facebook family. Worship with us on this morning. Yes. Hallelujah. Unto me. Come on, let's worship. Let's go to church, everybody. Let's go to church. Yes! Hallelujah! Come on. Tell God how much you love him.
Every praise.
He's worthy of it. Oh, yeah.
When you see me dancing, every praise, every praise.
Hallelujah.
Every praise,
yeah.
Every praise.
Every praise, yes. Come on, come on. That's right. We serve a God who's worthy of every praise. Amen. He is worthy, worthy, worthy. That's right. Put your hands together and worship the Lord. He is worthy of every praise, every praise, every praise. Here we go.
We love to call his name.
Yeah.
When we proclaim your great name, your great,
his great name. What's his name? What's his name?
Call your name. It's something not explained.
Not explained. When we proclaim your
great name.
We'll be right back.
on his great name. Come on. Open up your mouth and call on his great name right where you are. I tell you, you call on his name, things you'll feel a little bit better. Things will seem a little bit brighter. Oh, yes. Hallelujah. Yeah. Oh, yeah. Hallelujah. What's his name? King Jesus. We can call ya. Yes. Power in the name of Jesus. Yes. Power in your name. Y'all know it? There's power in his name.
There is power in the name of
Jesus. Oh, there's power.
Power in your name.
There's no other name under heaven. Oh, yes. You can call his name wherever you are. Say, Jesus. Call his name, you all. Yes. Anybody feel a shifting when you call on the name of Jesus? Come on, put your hands together and bless his name. We serve an awesome God. He is worthy, 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 worthy to be praised. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. There's a breaking when we call his name. He's turning it around when we call his name. There's a shifting when we call his name. There is deliverance when we call his name. There's healing when we call his name. There's peace when we call his name. There's joy when we call his name. Oh, yes. Come on, right where you are. Open up your mouths and call out. Call unto the name of the Lord. Shout with the name of the Lord. Shout his name. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. I don't know what you need God to do, but just shout Jesus. Oh, I promise you, you'll feel better. Call the name of Jesus. It will change the atmosphere. The name of Jesus will change the atmosphere. The name of Jesus will help you put some things in focus. Oh, yes, it might be blurry, but when you call on the name of Jesus, oh, my God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Well, if you're just tuning in with us, I'm Pastor Warren Vines. I'm the Associate Pastor of Holy and Whole Life-Changing Ministries International. Pastor Michelle C. Thomas is our pastor. I just want to thank you for being a part. I want to thank you for joining us on today. I want to thank you for signing in. We serve an awesome God. And I want to thank you because you could have been anyplace else, but you are here with us. And I don't count it as an accident because the God we serve is not a God of coincidence. Your steps have been ordered. You have been ordered by the Lord. The Lord has made it so that you would be with us on this morning. So I thank you so much for being a part. Thank you so much for tuning in. Thank you so much for worshiping the Lord with us on today. We love you, and we want to just say thank you because you could have been anywhere, and we do not take this time. We do not take this opportunity for granted. Amen? Amen. I want to just read a scripture on this morning. We want to read a scripture. We want to read our word. If you have your Bibles, the Lord led me to a scripture that I believe is very appropriate for where we are in our lives, where our country is on today. It is the 133rd Psalm. I'm going to read it from the New Living Translation. The 133rd Psalm, the New Living Translation. Amen. Amen. All right. If you have it, say, I have it. And if you don't, say, hold it. Just raise your hand and we'll just wait. Okay, we're going to wait. I see a few hands. Go ahead and please make sure you put comments in the face and make sure you comment. On Facebook. If you need prayer, whatever it is you need, we want to make sure we're in touch with you. Amen. The 133rd Psalm, reading from the New Living Translation. I need everybody to say harmony. Harmony. Yes, harmony. David says it like this. How wonderful it is. How pleasant when your brothers live together in harmony. That's verse one. The second verse, for harmony. Say harmony. Harmony is as precious as the fragrant anointing oil that was poured over Aaron's head, that ran down his beard and onto the border of his robe. Harmony is as refreshing as the dew from Mount Hebron that falls on the mountains of Zion. And the Lord has pronounced his blessing, even life forevermore. Harmony, everybody, say harmony. Look at that, how wonderful it is and how pleasant when brothers live together in harmony. With what is going on in our world right now, you all know we need harmony. We need harmony, and we need God to move in every heart and every human being, that God will allow us to dwell together in the spirit of unity. It's like a sweet fragrance. Amen. It's like a sweet fragrance, like the oil that ran down, I got a beard, you know, but ran down the beard of Aaron. It is a sweet fragrance. That's what it is. We need to dwell together in the spirit of unity. So we're going to take a moment to pray, and then we're going to move into our announcements. Father, just close your eyes and lift up your hands. Father, in the name of Jesus, we come before you right now, God, giving you thanks, giving you glory, giving you praise. For God, you are an awesome God. You are an awesome God, and we need you on today. We need you individually in our homes, individually in our lives, and we need you collectively as a nation. Father, I lift up my brothers and sisters in this country, and ask, oh God, that you allow the Spirit of the Lord to permeate our hearts, Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, that we will be joined together in unity, harmony, and peace, that we would feel your presence everywhere we go, that when we feel that we would feel your presence as we talk to our neighbors, that we would feel your presence as we drive and as we walk and as we live. Father, in the name of Jesus, anoint every person under the sound of my voice, oh God. Give us an anointing to live in the mighty name of Jesus, an anointing to live the life that you've called us to live. Help us to live on purpose, oh God. Help us to live in purpose. Help us to walk in purpose. In the name of Jesus, we call on the mighty name of Jesus, the mighty matchless name. There was no other name under heaven whereby men may be saved, where this world will change. We call on you now, God, to have your way. Touch our hearts in the name of Jesus. Touch our families in the name of Jesus. Touch our neighbors in the name of Jesus. Touch our brothers and sisters in the name of Jesus. Wrap your arms around us and give your angels charge and protection over us. We love you, God, and we praise you because we know that no weapon formed against us shall prosper. You're a great God, and you get the final say. We love you, and we thank you because we are victorious in Jesus. And it's in Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Yes, yes, yes. I'm excited about the God we serve because I'm trying to tell you there's nobody like him. There's nobody like him. And one thing about excitement is that it's contagious. So I hope that my excitement exudes through this camera and jumps onto you so that you can feel the excitement. I'm not a hype man. I'm just trying to tell you that I know the joy of the Lord is our strength. Amen. So I pray that you will feel the anointing, that you will feel the presence of God right where you are, because God is a life-changing God. Hallelujah. Is that all right? I'm going to keep saying hallelujah because it's the highest praise. But I am so thankful that we serve an awesome God. Amen. Let's move on toward our announcements. First and foremost, I want to thank everyone, and I want to give you thanks on behalf of Pastor Michelle and her family, that you, for all the love and all the support that you have given her and will continue to give them for her beloved son Fitz, going home to be with the Lord. We're so thankful that we really didn't lose him because we know where we can find him. Amen. And we are living our lives so that we will be able to see this young man again. And he was tragically taken from us. But we thank God that God is a God that is always in control. So I want to thank you for all the texts. I want to thank you for the emails. I want to thank you for all the prayers on behalf of our pastor. Please don't let those stop. Please continue to lift them up. They're going to continue to need your strength. They're going to continue to need your prayers. Lift up. Continue to be praying for the Holy and Whole family, because we need you. Everybody who is connected is affected. I can't say it any better than that. Everybody who is connected is affected on some level, and it touches each and every one of us differently. And there are going to be moments where you won't have the words to say, and you're fighting for the words to say. And listen, and it's okay to not have the words to say. It's okay to not be okay. God, we serve a God that meets you right where you are. He specializes in that. And so I just want to take a moment to thank you and thank you for your support and for your continued support for our pastor and her family. Amen. Next, I want to talk to you about our Bible study. We have Bible study every Wednesday. You can meet us back here every Wednesday at 7:30 p.m. for Bible study. And then we have our worship service on every Sunday at 11 a.m. So we're back here at 11 a.m. for worship service. And on this Sunday, we're going to have Children's Church with Sister Rinalda Richardson at 3 p.m., a wonderful, anointed woman of God. I promise you, get your children here because she's so creative, and I know that God has anointed her to do exactly what she's doing. Our children's lives are being touched. Our children's lives are being changed, and they're growing as a result of God using this woman of God in their life. So I want to thank you all for that. I want to invite you all to make sure, and if you have children, let them tune in at 3 o'clock to meet with Sister Rinalda. I promise you, you will not regret it. Amen. Amen. I think that's all of our announcements for now, but I definitely want to also give you the opportunity. I want to give you an opportunity, and I've went a little out of order. So I want to make sure that going back real quick, that as I've already welcomed you, we want to make sure that this is a time where you touch and agree. Okay. This is where we want to touch and agree with somebody. Wave to them, send them a selfie, air hug, whatever you have to do, where we touch and agree. Give somebody a big smile, a big God bless you. Send some emojis their way, whatever you need to do. Put some comments in there. We love you. We just want to touch and agree with you just to let you know that we care. But I see you. There you go. That heart. There you go. I see you, Brother Bruce. There you go. There we go. Yes. Just to let you know that you are loved. You are loved. You are thought about. You are cared for. Listen, we got a whole lot of stuff going on in this country. We got a whole lot of stuff going on in our lives individually. But I promise you this, the love of Christ makes a difference. So let's make sure that we're being loving, caring, and kind. Amen. I also want to give you the opportunity to give. If you want to give give your tithe and your offering, you can sign on to our website. Go to holyandwhole.org and push the give button. You can give there. It's right for those of us who are members of the church, and for those of you who are out there who want to give a gift or donation to the ministry, just go to holyandwhole.org and push the give, and the give portion of that, and you can give your gift there. Amen. It is really great because we serve a great God and who has given so much to us. And it's just an honor just to be able to give something back to him. And for those of us who are part of Holy and Hope, we know what our responsibilities are. And we want to make sure that we operate in that. Amen. To God be the glory. To God be the glory. We're going to have our anointed prayer warrior, Minister Ruth Jacob. She's going to come on and she's going to introduce our speaker for the day. And following Minister Ruth, we'll come back with another selection. And the next voice you will hear will be none other than our anointed speaker for the day, Elder Marion King. Come on, Minister Ruth.
Good morning, good morning, good morning, family. Oh, my, what a great day it is to be fellowshipping and gathering in your great name. I just want to, I am Minister Ruth of Holy and Whole Life Changing Ministries. I have the sincere pleasure and honor, hallelujah, of introducing to some and presenting to others, none other than one of our very own Holy and Whole leaders. Hallelujah, a dynamic leader, a woman of God after God's own heart. Hallelujah, a woman of faith. She's awesome in her own right. Hallelujah, because God ordained her for such a time as this to bless us with rhema word. Good feed, good eat. Hallelujah. And we're going to eat and partake on this day. Lord, I thank you for her. We thank you for her. And I would only ask that you would open up your ear gate, open up your heart gate to hear what it is that God has for the church and for us at Holy and Whole on this great day that he has made. Let not one word fall to the ground, but blessed, uplifted, and encouraged through each and every one of us. And it is Jesus' name that I pray and present this awesome woman of God today. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Y'all better get ready. You better get ready. Here we go.
You met me deep in my despair to show me you would never leave me there. You claimed me 'cause I was made for so much more. And I'm worth fighting for. Oh, heavy with the weight of my mistakes, you carried me and refused to let me sink under the pressure. You meant for me to soar. I am your child, and I'm worth fighting for. Eyes haven't seen, ears haven't heard all you have planned for me, and nothing can separate me from your love when there's so much more still worth fighting for. Now I'm moving by faith and not by sight towards victory. By the power of your might, you're straightening out my path, opening every door. I am your child, and I'm worth fighting for. Eyes haven't seen,
ears haven't heard all you have planned for me,
and nothing
can separate
me
from your love
when there's so much more. Your kingdom here is worth fighting
is worth buying for.
Eyes haven't seen. Ears haven't heard. Hallelujah, so much more worth fighting for, you all. Eyes haven't seen, ears haven't heard, so much more worth fighting for. Yes, so much more.
Come on, everybody. If you agree with that, put your hands together. Begin to open up your mouth and magnify the name of the Lord. Today is a good day to be in the presence of the Lord. We greet you from Surrey County, Virginia, Holy and Whole Life Changing Ministries International. We greet you in the name that is above every name, the name of Jesus, who by appointment is the Christ. We come to you on this morning, lifting up high the name of Jesus and greatly exalting his name because he's worthy. Anybody know he's worthy out there today? Amen, amen. And so we just want to connect with you. We want to share with you what thus saith the Lord on today, that we together will leave from this place. We together will move forward in the kingdom, built up, exalted. Leave from this place encouraged and strengthened. Leave from this place better than when we came. Amen, somebody. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. We certainly want to echo the words of Pastor Vines on the behalf of Pastor Michelle. And thank you, each and every one who has sent a note, sent a text, left something in the feed, sent a card, shown up to do something, come to support the family in this time in the passing of our brother Fitz. And we thank you, we thank you, we thank you on the behalf of the Thomas family and on the behalf of the Holy and Whole family. We thank you. And we ask that you would do exactly what the ministers and those who were echoing great expressions on yesterday, that you would continue, because you know now the aftercare begins. And so we want to encourage you to be a part of the aftercare, that the family will continue to be able to feel the love. They will continue to be able to feel the arms wrapped around them virtually, of course, because we're still practicing social distancing. But please, by all means, don't let the cards and the text and just the notes of we love you stop. Amen? Amen, amen. We're happy about Jesus on today and happy about the word that he has given us. I invite you to turn with us to two passages of scripture, in particular Galatians chapter 6, verse 9. And then if you would go with us to Romans 8, 28 through 31. Again, Galatians 6 and 9, and then Romans 8, 28 through 31. Amen. Amen. Come on and bow your heads with us. Dear kind and heavenly Father, we thank you now. We thank you, God, for this day, because it is the day that you have made. And so on purpose, we give you praise now. On purpose, we give you the glory now. On purpose, we lift up your name and we call you holy, because you alone are holy. On purpose, we say thank you for all things, because you do all things well. We thank you now for last night's lying down and for this morning's uprising. And we thank you, oh God, that when you touched us, our minds were yet stayed on you. And we thank you now that when you touched us, we had a sufficient amount of health and strength to get up on our own and do what we needed to do for ourselves. And we thank you now that we have the presence of mind to come to a place of worship now, even if it's in our homes, over the airwaves. It is now a sanctified place of worship. And so we thank you for the opportunity to come and to fellowship and to hear what you have to say to us. Now we ask that you would anoint us afresh. We ask, oh God, in the name of Jesus, that you would do for us what we cannot do for ourselves. We ask in the name of Jesus that you would meet us at the point of our need, and that you, God, would attend to our need, and that you, God, would do something special on our behalf, and that when we leave this broadcast on today, our testimony will be it was good for us to have been here. Now we thank you, we magnify you, we lift you, and we give you great praise. It is in the name of your son, Jesus, that we lift this prayer, and we are in agreement to say amen. Amen. In the book of Galatians, I'm going to be reading this morning from the New Living Translation. Book of Galatians, chapter number 6, verse 9, simply says this: so let's not get tired of doing what is good. At just the right time, we will reap a harvest of blessings if we don't give up. Amen. And then go with us to the book of Romans. Again, we'll be reading from the New Living Translation, chapter 8, verses 28 through 31. And if you have your highlighter and or your pencil and you don't mind underlining or highlighting in your Bible, we certainly ask you to underline some things as we read along. Verse number 28, and we know that God causes everything to work together for the good of those who love God and, underline, are called according to his purpose for them. Verse number 29, for God knew his people in advance, underline knew in advance, and he chose them to become like his son, underline chose to become like his son, so that his son would be the firstborn among many brothers and sisters. Verse number 30, and having chosen, underline chosen, and having chosen them, he called them to come to him, and having called them, watch this, he gave them right standing with himself. And having given them right standing, he gave them his glory. Verse number 31, what shall we say then about such wonderful things as these? If God is for us, who can be against us? Can anybody say, if God is for me, who can be against me? Amen, somebody? If we were to take a subject on today, our subject would be, look past what you can see. Look past what you can see. I always like to break that down a little bit and put it in a place where we can reach for it later. And I would say the evidence you're looking for is way past what you can see. Tell somebody that on this morning. The evidence you're looking for is way past what you can see. We are living in an evidence-driven, evidence-gathering, survey-pushing society. And we have to have evidence for schoolhouses and evidence for businesses and evidence for the stock market and evidence that this is going to work and evidence that that's going to work. And so when we come back to our private selves, to our human selves, we likewise begin to look for evidence that we're on track to our destiny. We want to know, is there some evidence that confirms that it is my time? You know, this one has prophesied to me and that one has preached to me and I've heard the word and I've heard the songs going forth and I believe that it's my time, but is there any evidence that suggests that it's my time? Is there any evidence that suggests that I'm not where I am right now in my experience or on my journey by accident? Is there any evidence to suggest that God really does not make a mistake, or he has not made a mistake concerning me? Is there any evidence to suggest that I'm not in over my head? Evidence bearing, evidence gathering society. Listen, in our humanness, we look for evidence, we look for signs, we look for suggestions, we look for hints with our natural eye to confirm all of those things that I just mentioned. What if, or what would happen if we don't have any satisfactory physical signs, any satisfactory physical suggestions, any satisfactory physical hints to point us in the direction that we are leaning and depending on? What if those things are failing us? What if there are no physical signs right now that we're coming out of this pandemic okay? What if there are no physical signs that in the middle of this our economic plight that we are going to survive? What are the evidences, physical evidences, that in the face of social injustices, that this 4,000 first year will be the year of ultimate change? What are the physical evidences? What are the physical signs and suggestions and hints that when our loved ones are no longer with us, that we will be all right? And we keep looking for signs and suggestions and hints in the natural. But I came to suggest to you and came to leave in your hearing Hebrews 13 verse 5, clause number 3, which the Lord simply says, I will never leave you nor forsake you. So what if all we have today is God's word? Is God's word still good enough? Ask somebody, is God's word still good enough for you? Amen. When we look at the concept of the pandemic, watch this. By definition, a pandemic is a disease or a dis-ease that is prevalent in a whole country or across the whole world. So when we begin to look at those four things that I just mentioned, those four specific things can individually qualify as pandemics: COVID-19, economic unrest, social unrest, and then loss of loved ones. All of those in and of themselves, because we are experiencing them across this world. Are we allowing situational pandemics to cause us to lose sight of the impact that just God's word has? Let me ask you that again. Are we allowing situational pandemics to cause us to lose sight of the impact that just God's word should have in our lives? In the beginning, God spoke it, and it was. Listen, we've just finished the spiritual journey from celebration of Christ's crucifixion, burial, resurrection, all the way to Pentecost. And what we recognize along that way is that journey has to have more than a 1 or 2 day effect in our lives and in our faith. The impact from that journey should have us on a daily basis hungering and thirsting for more insight. Listen, insight does not stop pain and suffering, but it is a behavior modifier while in the pain and suffering. Can I say that again? Insight does not stop pain and suffering, but it is a behavior modifier while in the pain and the suffering. So say again with me, the evidence you're looking for is way past what you see. So my assignment today is to disrupt the dialogue that keeps coming out of the spirit of what if. It is to activate the prayer warriors and those persons who have been identified as generals in the kingdom. It is to shut down pity parties, and it is to assassinate the spirit of assuming. Listen, assuming that because we are who we are, because we are the chosen of God, the called out among them, we should have a special privilege of little to no suffering. I came for you today. I came to disrupt the dialogue. I came to activate prayer warriors and generals. I came to shut down pity parties, and I came to assassinate the spirit of assumption. The evidence I'm looking for is way past anything that I can see. It is infinitely impossible, listen, with our finite minds to fully grasp or comprehend the mind and the move of God with reference to foreknowledge and predestination. But in the letter to the Ephesians, Paul uses three specific words, and I want you to write those down because we're going to go back and look at them this week in Bible study. He uses three specific words that will help us develop a better understanding or better insight of God's foreknowledge and predestination for us. In Ephesians 1 and 4, the word says, according as he, meaning God, hath chosen us in him before the foundation of the world. So the first word is chosen. Listen, chosen refers to God's election of all who accept Christ. It refers back to the eternal past. Ephesians 1 and 11, in whom also we have obtained an inheritance, being predestined according to the purpose of him who worketh all things after the counsel of his own will. So the second word is predestination. Predestination refers to the inheritance of all who believe. It refers to the eternal future. Then Ephesians 2 and 10, for we are his workmanship. Touch yourself and say, I am his workmanship. Created in Christ Jesus unto good works, which God hath before ordained that we should walk in them. Third word, preordained. Preordained refers to our works in Christ Jesus. It speaks to the living present. So, listen, the third truth or the third word links man back to the first two. It shows God's will, and it shows man's response to insight in the plan of salvation. Okay, so let's go a little further. How do we then see past what we see so that we can do the four things we talked about? So that we can disrupt dialogue, the dialogue of the enemy that comes to steal, to rob, so that we can activate prayer warriors and generals, so that we can shut down pity parties, and so that we can assassinate the spirit of assumption. I got three things for you. Number one, get out of your own head. Thank you, Peyton. You were talking this morning, and I was hoping that you and Pastor Vines wouldn't go any further because you were so much right there in one of my points. Stop operating in your own strength. Listen, I read this short story a while back, and it's called The System of Dr. Tarr and Professor Fetter by Edgar Allan Poe. And in there is this little piece of the short story that I thought was time worthy to mention. And I've sort of held on to it and used it in different things. And it simply says this: the time will arrive when you will learn to judge for yourself of what is going on in the world without trusting to the gossip of others. Believe nothing you hear and only half of that you see. Our problem, men and women of God, our problem, those of you who are under the sound of my voice, is that we're stuck on what we see, and we put too much value in what we see with our natural eye. But I came to say today that what we are looking for, the evidence that we are looking for, is way past what we can see with these. It's way past what we can see with these, and it's way past what we can see when we put these on to get a little help. We need a spiritual insight. We need the Holy Spirit to give us revelation. We need to have a discerning spirit about what's being said, about what we are hearing, so we know as ambassadors how to proceed. We need not to lean to our own understanding. And so let's move a little further. When we began to look at those three special things that we want to do this week. Number one, get out of your own head. Stop operating in your own strength. Proverbs 3:5-6, write it down. Trust in the Lord with all thine heart and lean not to thine own understanding. In all thy ways, acknowledge him and he shall direct thy path. All right, number two. Number one was get out of your own head. Number two, embrace the power of chosen. We have been chosen. We just read in the scriptures. Listen, we read it in the scriptures in verse 29. For God knew his people in advance and he chose them. And then in verse 30, and having chose them, he set some particular things in motion for them because he knew what he alone put in us. He knew what he alone would require of us. He knew what he alone would need us to do, how he would need us to be an example in the earth realm so that others could see his glory, so that others could connect to his goodness, so that others could call him Lord and Savior, receive him as their personal Lord and Savior. He knew. We don't know. And even now in our present situation, we don't know how God is going to use us. But I encourage you today to be available for him to use you however he sees fit. Be available for God to use you however he needs to use you. Don't lose sight of the fact that we've been chosen for this. We've been handpicked for this. And even though we don't feel like we can do it, even though we don't feel like we can get it done, even though we don't feel like we can go through all of this, we're able to do it because God chose us. Number one, get out of your own head. Number two, embrace the power of chosen. 1 Corinthians 1:27, write it down. But God hath chosen the foolish things of the world, listen, to confound the wise. And God hath chosen the weak things of the world to confound the things which are mighty. We're going to come back and break that down and talk about it on Wednesday. But I need that to resonate in your spirit because God did not allow us to get to mighty places of wealth and mighty places of having all that we want to have in mighty places of our names meaning something in the community before he chose to use us. He chose to use us and he chose us before he positioned us to end up in those places. And he chose us before that for a reason, so that when he moved, so that when his hand was upon us, that people would see the move of God upon our lives, that people would be able to resonate with the fact that if he did it for her, he can do it for me. He chose us to go through. so that men and women would know that he's able to deliver, that he's able to save, that he's able to rescue, that he's able to sustain us even when we don't think we have anything left. He's able. Somebody say he's able. And so I came today to encourage us all to look past what we see with these. We've got to look through our spiritual lens. Number one, get out of your own head. Number two, embrace the power of chosen. Number three, recognize, listen, the inherent promise of predestination. Inherent means the existing of a prominent or permanent and essential characteristic or attribute. So recognize the inherent promise of predestination. Get out of your own head, my living present. Embrace the power of chosen, my eternal past. And then recognize inherent promise of predestination, my eternal future. Jeremiah 29:11, you know the scripture. Come on and read it with me. For I know the thoughts that I think toward you, saith the Lord, thoughts of peace and not of evil, to give you an expected end. And so we spend too much time trying to glorify our end, trying to glorify the thing that God has intended for us. Well, all of it may not look glorious. All of my journey may not look glorious, but God is still God, and he's still able, and he's still on the throne, and he's still ruling in the affairs of men, and he's still making good decisions toward us that benefit the kingdom. Because after all, why are we his? We are his because we have a special task. We're his because we're supposed to be salt and light in the land. We're his because he's using us to draw others. And so some of my task, some of my go-through, some of my persecution, some of my downtime is not going to be just for me. Some of it is going to be so that men and women and boys and girls and those who are existing in lack and those who don't have a hope can see the salvation of the Lord, can see that he's able to do. I came today to call forth the generals and to call forth the prayer warriors that have been assigned to this day and to this time. Listen, generals are a prepared position that have been readied for a deeper type of warfare. Generals have been delivered from something. You can't be delivered you cannot be delivered from what you refuse to go through. Generals can take something. Generals who won't faint at the sight of blood. And not necessarily blood where you cut me physically, but blood where I'm cut spiritually, emotionally. Who won't faint at the sight of blood. Who won't faint at the sight of tests and trials. Who won't faint in the middle of go through. Generals who don't have a problem taking the enemy out. This is who I came for. Generals and prayer warriors. because in the middle of this situational pandemic that has four specific avenues, it's got COVID-19, it's got economic failure, it's got social unrest, and then it's got loss of loved ones. We're experiencing this all over the country, all over the world. Where is the church? The evidence that we should be looking for should be, and it has to be, way past what we see, way past what we feel in the natural, way past what our intellectual understanding avails us to. It has to be more than that. So I encourage you today to come back on Wednesday, where we get a chance to interact with one another, where we get a chance to dissect this and see what God is saying to the church, saying to us in these situational pandemics. I encourage you on today, if you don't know Christ in the pardoning of your sins, I encourage you, I challenge you to choose a better way. I challenge you to type in the feed, "I want to be saved." I challenge you to try Jesus on the day. You tried everything else. You keep looking with your natural eye, looking for evidences that it's going to be all right, looking for evidences that, this will work out on my behalf, looking for evidences that things will come through. Well, it's not in the physical. It's not in the natural. This is not a physical fight. This is a spiritual fight. It's spiritual warfare. And so we have to have people that have been armed and ready. We have to have prayer warriors. We have to have generals. We have an abundance of foot soldiers, an abundance of people who are waiting to be told what to do. How many of us will take the charge and step up and do what God is sending us to do without needing a special hall pass and special permission to get it done? How many of us would take on the challenge and meet that enemy of our soul head on in the spirit? How many of us, if you don't know Christ and the pardoning of your sins, we present Christ to you today. Type in the feed, "I want to be saved." If you just want prayer on today, you want some strength, you need some strength, you need to be encouraged because you feel like you've been fighting this fight by yourself, type in the feed, "I need prayer today." Oh my God, He came that you might have life and that you might have it more abundantly. If you notice throughout the scriptures, most every situation, most every apostle, most every time that people have been gathered together to do something for the kingdom, to fight, to give a word, listen, they were not sent alone to do it. So those of you who have put yourselves in isolation, looking for signs and suggestions and hints that it's going to be all right, that tomorrow will be a better day, we came to help you see that you got to see it before you see it. You got to see it in the spirit before you see it in the natural. And the only way you can see it in the spirit is that you are connected to the source. Hey, my God. Come on and bow your heads with us. Woo. Dear kind and heavenly Father, we thank you now. We thank you for this day. We thank you for your divine purpose. We thank you for the opportunity, O God, to see it before we see it. We thank you for reminding us that we have to look past what our natural eyes can see and perceive, what our natural feelings can turn over in order to see what it is you have for us. And so on today, if there be anyone under the sound of my voice who does not know you in the pardoning of their sin, we ask in the name of Jesus that you would save now to the uttermost. In the name of Jesus, we ask, O God, that you would rescue the lost. We ask, O God, that you would reclaim the backslider. We ask in the name of Jesus that you would send now hope to the hopeless, that you would send now comfort to the weary. We ask in the name of Jesus that you would do a new thing. Send now fresh anointings to those of us who are holding on. Fresh anointings to those of us who need help on today. Fresh anointings, oh God, to those of us who feel a little bit on the weak side. Help us, God, to stretch out on you. Help us, God, to totally lean and depend on you. Help us, God, to be salt and light. Help us now to be helpers of one another, that our brothers, our sisters can lean on us as we lean on you. Help us to push into you, that we will forever give your name the glory. We'll forever give your name the honor. We'll forever give your name the praise. We thank you. We lift you. We count it done in Jesus' name. And the people of God begin to bless his name and to begin to give him glory, begin to honor him because he's worthy. Oh my God, he's worthy. Somebody say he's worthy. He's worthy. He's worthy. He's worthy. He's worthy. He's worthy. He's worthy of the honor. He's worthy of the praise. He's worthy of the glory. He's worthy of my trust. He's worthy. Oh God, we bless your name. We thank you today. We invite you to come back at 3 o'clock and to participate, those of you who have youth, to allow them to participate with our youth ministry. Sister Rinalda Richardson, the Lord has anointed her for this task and is using her mightily in the kingdom. You can trust your children with her. Amen, somebody. We bless God for you. We invite you to come back on Wednesday night, that we will break out this word and open it up and see what else the Lord has to say to us. We invite you, oh God, if you don't have a church home, to join Holy and Whole. We invite you to be a part of us. We invite you to give and support the ministry, that the word will go forth continually with power, with anointing, that the people of God will be energized and supported and helped to reach others, that the kingdom will be advanced. We bless God for you. We bless God for you joining us on today. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, God. Hallelujah. There's only one way. We can't leave this out. There's only one way to leave a Holy and Whole meeting, a Holy and Whole service, a Holy and Whole Bible study, a Holy and Whole gathering. And that is to go forward, go forward, go forward in Jesus' name. We're in gallery view now. Come on, y'all. Go forward. Go forward. Go forward in Jesus' name. One more time. Go forward. Go forward. In Jesus' name. Come on, one more time. Go forward. Go forward. Go forward. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen. Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, God. Thank you for joining us on today. Woo. Thank you.